We serve a great God.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. And nobody, amen, in the universe can say anything different.
Yes.
Amen. Because all we got to do is just look around us.
Yes.
Amen. Just go out and look at the, amen, the heavens. Amen. And look at, amen, the world itself, and it's still standing.
Yes.
And it's standing because of the word of God.
Yes.
Amen. I want to say good morning to all of our amen viewers this morning. Amen. On this blessed, amen, Resurrection Day. Amen. All over the world, people are celebrating Easter. Amen. Praise God. And when I think about Easter, amen, I think about, amen, Jesus. Amen. Getting out of that grave. Oh, just for me and you. Amen. Praise God. And then sending back to his Father. Amen. And the Bible teaches us he now sits on the right hand of his Father.
Yes.
And he makes intercessions for us. Amen. But what brings me joy is that if Jesus had not risen, amen, then my living would be in vain.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Praise God. So today, amen, I hope everybody, amen, have the spirit of thanksgiving. Amen. And give him praise for just being God. Amen. There is no other God like him. Amen. Praise God. So we're here this morning. Amen. On the, amen, second Sunday. Amen. In April, which is our Power Sunday. Amen. With a message. Amen. I just believe it's going to bless those who, amen, praise God, are listening to us this morning. Amen. Now, I might as well go ahead and tell you, I'm not going to be able to finish it today. Amen. Within 1 hour. So you'll have to tune in Thursday in the morning. Amen. To get, amen, the rest of the message. Amen. You know, the Holy Spirit is so awesome. Amen. In the lives of his children. Amen. Praise God. Because I got this message. Amen. Praise God. In bits and pieces. Amen. I woke up one day last week and I heard this phrase, amen, just running around in my head. And I said, what is the Holy Ghost trying to tell me? Amen. Praise God. And it's amazing. Some of y'all gonna think it's funny. Amen. I got the first part of this text. Amen. This morning I was, amen, doing some housework. Amen. And I was, amen, 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 rearranging in order the shoes in my closet. Amen. And I heard Maya Angelou say, amen, does my sassiness upset you? Amen. Praise God. And by that time, amen, I heard the Holy Ghost. He began to talk to me. He says, amen. He said, tell Zion her king is coming. Amen. And I said, I began to, amen, search the scriptures. And we're going to begin talking out of the gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 21, verse 5 and 10. 5 through 10. Amen. And the second part of that text said, he said, tell the world I'll be passing through soon. Then the third part of it is, he said, tell Calvary it won't have to wait too long. And then he said to me, tell the tomb there will be a 3-day delay because I'm going to rise on the third day on my way home. Ha. Amen. Somebody say amen in this house. Amen. Praise God. Some confused. Amen. This is part one. Amen. In St. Matthew chapter 21 says, beginning at verse 5, tell ye the daughters of Zion, behold, thy king cometh unto thee. Amen. He's coming. He's meek, and he's sitting upon an ass and a colt, the fold of an ass. And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, and bought the ass and the coat, and put on them their clothes. Somebody said their clothes. And they set him their own. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Amen. As if a king was coming. Amen. Others cut down branches from the trees and strewed it in the way. Amen. Praise God. And not only that, the Bible says that the multitudes went before and that followed, crying, saying, Hosanna, amen, the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Amen, praise God. Now, some people say hallelujah is the highest praise, but I believe this is the highest praise. Amen. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Amen. And when he was coming to Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, what is this? And the multitude said, this is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee. Amen, amen, amen. Tell Zion her king is coming. Amen. Tell the world that he's going to be passing through. Amen. Tell Calvary, amen, you won't have to wait too long. Tell the tomb there going to be a 3-day delay. Because I will arise on the 3rd day on my way home, which is called Resurrection Day, and which we are now celebrating this morning. Amen, praise God. Amen. I wonder sometime what it would have been like if Satan had not showed up on Genesis 3:1-5. When he assaulted the intelligence and the wisdom of God as he counseled, what God had, the instructions that God had given to Adam and Eve, he destroyed it, the truth. Amen, praise God. Watch his language. Amen. In the King James Version in Genesis, and the serpent was very subtle, that in the beast of the field which the Lord God had made. He was subtle. He was very wise, very intelligent. And he said unto the woman, yea, as God said, ye shall not eat of the tree of the garden. He asked her a question. Hey, wait a minute. Did God say that? Amen. The woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden. Amen. Amen. God has said, ye shall not eat it of it, neither should you touch it, lest you die. And the serpent said unto the woman, oh, you shall not surely die. For God does know that in the day you eat thereof, then your eyes shall be open, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food and that it was pleasant, amen, to the eyes, and the tree was desired to make one wise, she took the fruit thereof, did eat it, gave it unto her husband with her, and he did eat. And the eyes of Bible said the eyes of them both were open. And they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves aprons. And they heard the voice of the Lord walking, amen, in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves, amen, from the presence of the Lord, God among them, amen, who was in the garden. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. When you look at that, that sets amen, the stage. Amen. For a great amen movement. Amen. By God. Amen. To restore man back unto him. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. I begin, amen, to continue, amen, to look at, amen, the word of God, amen, to try to help us, amen, to understand just how great God is. Amen, praise God. Amen, I look at him. Amen, praise God. Amen, the plan was set in motion. Amen, through. Amen, what the enemy done in the Garden of Eden. Amen. Amen. His crisis coming has been instigated by the love of God for his creation, because Satan has entered and interrupt God's plan for his people. The world's first diabolic scheme has entered the Garden of Eden, and he has been done by a fallen angel who was first called in Isaiah 14:14. The Bible says, how are you fallen from heaven, O day star, son of dawn? Then undergoes a name change. Now he is called Satan, who makes his way into the wisest animal God created, the serpent. Hidden that word serpent. Amen. Praise God. Is the word repent. If you rearrange the letters. Amen. Rearrange the letter in Satan, and you will find the word tan, which reveals a color. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
He comes to Eve while she is alone, because he loves talking to us when we are by ourselves. He speaks a convincing amen word and tempts her with one question. Did God really say, oh, y'all better talk in here.
Amen.
Amen, that you couldn't eat from the tree of life. The question comes to my mind. I just say to know what God had said. Was he eardropping on the conversation? But he is a spirit also and needs humanity to carry out his plan to make God look bad in the eyes of his creatures. Amen. This puts Satan in the category of a murderer, a terrorist, and a mischief maker.
Yes.
Now that I've laid that little foundation, the plan is now set in motion. Tell the world I will be passing through. The announcement of Jesus' birth began not with his physical birth, but with his mother, the Virgin of Mary. Her response to Gabriel's announcement that she had been chosen to be the mother of God's son, in which at that time Mary conceived the Son of God, which was by the Holy Ghost. Still in his mother's womb, Jesus sanctifies John the Baptist. Amen. Before his birth, when Mary goes to visit her cousin. Luke 1:41-45 says, and it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the baby leaped in her womb. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost, and she spoke out with a loud voice and saying, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. And whence is this to be, said the mother of my Lord, shall come to me? For lo, as soon as the voice of thy salutation sounded in my ear, the babe leaped in my womb for joy. Oh my God. Amen. The baby, amen, testified to what was spoken. And blessed is she that believed, for there shall be a performance of those things which was told her from the Lord. And Mary said, my soul do magnify the Lord. I want to tell you, it's one thing when your mouth magnifies him. It's another thing when your soul magnifies him. Amen. Have you ever had a soul praise?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. You can have a soul praise and not even make a sound, an audible sound. Amen. But your soul just start rejoicing. Amen. Amen. I've had a couple of those. Amen. Since, and I want you to know I couldn't contain myself.
Yes.
Amen. Praise my soul started praising God. It didn't matter how much I tried to be keep quiet and quiet. Amen. But after a while, it broke loose. And somebody else knew that my soul was magnifying the Lord. Jesus is born in Bethlehem, known as Christmas is to today. And this is what is called the Nativity. Amen. Matthew 2:1 says, when an angel in a dream warned Joseph that King Herod was searching for Jesus to kill him. Joseph and his family moved to Egypt after the death of King Herod. Joseph, his wife, and Jesus returned to Israel, not to Bethlehem, but to Nazareth. Because the question will soon be asked, can any good thing come out of Nazareth? Amen. And what I want to do is kind of walk you through. Amen. Amen to some of the things that Jesus did on his way to the cross. Amen. The Bible says he was circumcised on the 8th day after his birth. Has to submit to the Messianic law and shed first, and it symbolized the shedding of his blood for our sake. For Luke puts it this way in chapter 2, verse 21 through 22, on the 8th day, when it was time to be circumcised, amen, the child, amen, he was named Jesus, and amen, which was the name that was given to him by the angels, amen, before he was conceived. Amen. Jesus is on his way. Amen. To Calvary. Amen. But he got to pass through before he gets there. Amen. You find him in the temple. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Amen. As he was circumcised, he submitted himself to, amen, the Mosaic law. In the temple, is another submission of the law of Moses. Jesus is present in the temple. At 40 days after his birth, as the firstborn son of Mary, who does belong to God. Luke says that when the days stipulated by Moses for purification were complete, they took him up to Jerusalem to offer him to God as a command in God's law. Every male who opened the womb shall be a holy offering unto God, and also to sacrifice a pair of doves or two young pigeons prescribed by the law. Wouldn't it be nice if fathers and parents, when their kids are first born, to bring them and offer them up to the Lord? Hallelujah. Wouldn't it be nice? Glory to God. If we can stop doing our own thing long enough, stop being so busy. Amen. After the children are born, while they get babies. And they used to do this years ago, but they don't do a lot of it now. Amen. Mothers will come and parents will come and say, Lord, I give my child back to you. Take care of him. Amen. Make something great out of it. Help us to be good parents. Help us to live the life, amen, that they can see. Amen. You and us, and they will glorify the Father which is in heaven. Amen. Another aspect of Jesus' life was, amen, the flight into Egypt. Amen. When the King Herod, amen, was alerted to the birth of the Messiah by the wise men, the first thing he did was order a massacre for all male children under the age of 3. Amen. You see, the devil has always been after Jesus. Let the church say amen. And let me tell you something about Satan. Amen. That I want, amen, praise God, to reiterate this morning, is that the devil would attack, amen, when a prophecy is being fulfilled. Amen. When the Lord has promised you something, amen, look out for in that time. Let the church say amen. Look out for the enemy. Amen, to come against you, because he don't want you to receive amen, what the Lord has spoken into your life. Let the church say amen. Amen, praise God. Not only that, amen. I often say that once you get your blessing, the enemy is going to try to make sure that you don't enjoy it. But you got to declare and decree. Amen. You got to stand firm in your faith. And firm in the word of God. And I want to encourage you that if nobody never speaks a word of your life, amen, the Bible has already spoken. Amen. And the word is like a shoe nail. Let the church say amen. Jesus says, before one jot or tittle of my word will fail, he said, heaven and earth will pass away. And I'd rather be in the word than to be in heaven and earth. Oh, come on, somebody. Why? Because he is the word. And every victory that needs to be won, he's already won.
Amen.
Let's just say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, amen. Harris is after Jesus. And you know, I talked about the other son and boy, amen, the providence of God being under God's protective custody. And when you are under the protective custody of the Lord, God has a way of hiding you from me. Amen. Amen. The Bible says, Joseph took Mary and Jesus to safety in Egypt. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Matthew 13 and 13 said, when they had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in the dream and said, Joseph, get up. Whoever told you God won't talk to you? Amen. If he don't talk, God knows he got an angel at his amen, beck and call. Angel said, Joseph, get up. Amen. Take the child and his mother. And I want you to escape. Amen. And go to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you. For Herod is going to search for the child to kill him. Amen. The devil didn't want him to make it to Calvary. Let your sin amen. They wanted to make it to Calvary because when he got to Calvary, the sin debt was going to be paid. Hallelujah. So the devil said, I got to get him before he gets to Calvary. Because when he gets to Calvary and die, he's got to be buried. Hallelujah. Amen. And I want to get him because once he dies, he's going to resurrect. Bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And so the Bible said he got up and took the child and his mother during the night and left for Egypt. Amen. Where he stayed until the death of Herod. Amen. amen, and so was the fear that the Lord has said through the prophet, out of Egypt I call my sons. And so he has to go. A prophecy is pushing him. It's already been written. Amen. And you can't change it. Let it just say amen. Amen. In our life, there's some things, amen, that has been set before us for us to endure. You can't change it. And since I, amen, let me talk about me. And I don't want about out there to get offended. Since I can't change it. Amen. Then I need to make sure I'm on the side of the one that can bring me through. Let the church say amen. And then many times people want changes, but don't want to live holy. And can I tell you, you can have the children's bread. Amen. Come on, somebody. You can live any kind of way and try to eat the children's bread.
That's right.
Okay, that's another subject for another day. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. There are certain things as I did my research called the hidden yields in Nazareth. After Herod's death, when the danger of Jesus had passed, the Holy Family returns to Egypt to live in Nazareth. For the age of about 3 until the age of about 30, which was the beginning of his public ministry, Jesus resides with Joseph until his death and Mary in Nazareth, and lives as an ordinary life of religious obedience to Mary and Joseph. Wait a minute. Here's Jesus. His father is dead. His mother is left. And now he lives with his mama. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
And he lives a religious life. Let the church say amen. Amen. What a question might come up. Amen. To Barry. Amen. I had thought about it until I just made the statement. Inquisitive minds. Why does Jesus, amen, the history says that he lived a religious life and not a saved life. Because without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. And the truth of the matter, and I say this all the time, you got to be careful how you a type religion. Y'all better talk in here. Because salvation came out of religion. Amen. Jesus said, I didn't come to destroy the law, but I came to fulfill it. And this is one of the things that, amen, that upset the scribes and the Pharisees. So, amen, Jesus is coming, amen, fulfilling what they had already been taught, what had brought them through, amen, which was the law of Moses. Then all of a sudden, here come a strange man out of nowhere, amen, telling them, amen, the day of the law is over. I'm here. Amen. You didn't see me, but I really was wrapped up in the law, waiting to be revealed.
Yes.
Let the church say amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. So I looked at Jesus. Amen. Residing with his mother. Amen. Very obedient. Amen. Manual labor. As a carpenter at his father's side. These years are hidden because the gospel records very little detail of his life at this time. With one major exception. That at the age of 12, you find him in the temple. Jesus accompanied Mary and Joseph and many of their relatives to Jerusalem to celebrate the Jewish feast days. And on the return, Mary and Joseph realized he's not with the family. Think about the panic. Amen. You went to amen, a feast. Amen. You know you had him with you. Because this is the only son that they have. Amen. When the church had a good time. All of a sudden, all of you were way back home. You look. And your only son you can't find. Just think about the panic. amen, of those parents. The Bible says they return to Jerusalem. They find him in the temple teaching men who were much older than he was. The meaning of the scripture. Wait a minute. A 12-year-old teaching doctors and lawyers. Yes. A 12-year-old.
Yes.
Oh my God, filled with the knowledge of God. Amen. Teaching the doctors and the lawyers. Let the church say, amen. Imagine that. Amen. That would have blew my mind too. Here I am, 71 year old, and a 12 year old is teaching me. Amen. What I don't know and ought to know.
That's right.
Come on, somebody. Amen. Tell Zion, I'm passing through. Amen. The baptism of John. Jesus' public life begins around 30. He is baptized by John the Baptist in the Jordan River. The Bible says the Holy Spirit descends in the form of a dove, and a voice from heaven declared, "This is my beloved Son." Amen, in whom I'm well pleased. Amen. Now everybody won't agree with me. But this is some years ago when I was meditating. Amen. And studying the word of God. Amen. When it said a dove ascended down upon him and lit upon him. Amen. Amen. And the Lord said to me, amen, praise God, that's a sign of being baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. The Spirit might come and might go away, but when he sits there, come on, somebody. Amen. Amen. And doesn't leave you. That's a sign that you have been baptized and filled. Amen. In the Holy Ghost. Let the church say amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. So, amen. Matthew says this way. Then Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized. Amen. But John tried to really deter and stop him, saying, wait a minute, Jesus. Amen. I need to be baptized by you. Amen. And here you are coming for amen, to baptize you. Jesus said, John, it's okay. I got this. Amen. Amen. So he says to him, amen, let it be so now. It is proper for us to do this to fulfill our righteousness. And the Bible said, and then John consented. Amen. Consenting means he said, okay, he agreed. Let us say amen. Amen. So what is really saying here? And this was so amazing. Amen. Praise God. John the Baptist received, amen, the Holy Ghost, in his mother's womb. Come on, somebody. Amen. Before Jesus was even born. Amen. Now he is baptized in the Son of God. Who else can do it? My God. He sanctified enough to do it. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Then we find the temptation of Jesus. After his baptism, Jesus spends 40 days and 40 nights in the desert, fasting and praying and being tried by Satan.
Yeah.
Emerging from the trial, he is revealed as the new Adam who stayed true to God. Amen. Where Adam failed. You see, praise God, when you're in, amen, the desert by yourself, being tempted by the enemy, don't let nobody tell you you can't stay faithful to God. You can, because Jesus did. Amen. You know the story, all the temptation the enemy tried to get him to do, to give up his identity. But Jesus had a word for him. He said, it's written. Amen. And since it's written, amen, I got to walk through what is written. Oh, y'all better talk in here. I just got this revelation that when you're going through, this is why you need to fall in love with your Bible.
Jesus.
It's all right to like Facebook. It's all right to like Twitter. It's all right to like your laptop and your social media, but honey, you better fall in love with your Bible. Because the Bible is the most authentic truth there is. Amen. In the world. So after the baptism, Jesus, amen, spends 40 days and nights in the desert. He's fasting and praying. Amen. After being tried, he emerges from the trial. Amen. With victory. Let the church say amen. And the strangest thing about that, amen, of the faith, number for faith, is this. The Bible says the Spirit led him into the wilderness to be tempted. Not Jesus. Not the Son of God. Led him.
Yes.
Amen. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted. Come on, y'all.
Yes.
How did the Spirit led him into a wilderness by himself?
Mama.
To be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward hunger. And when the tempter came to him, he said, "If thou be the Son of God, command these stones to be turned to bread." Hallelujah. How many of you know that if you ever gone on a 40-day fast, if you can make it the first week, the other three, amen, is nothing but great. And when you come off, you really don't want much to eat. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And then we see Jesus passing through, amen, the wedding of Cana, which is his first miracle. Jesus turned water into wine at the request of his mother. Then you see him moving towards Calvary, preaching the gospel. Jesus' public ministry begins with the proclamation of the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And this is when he started calling his disciples. The book of the gospel covers this portion of Christ's life. He's on his way to Calvary. Look, then you look at the miracles. Along with his preaching of the gospel, Jesus performed miracles. People get their hearing back. Amen. The multiplication of the loaves and the fish, the casting out of demons, the raising of Lazarus from the dead. These signs of Christ's power confirms his teaching and his claim to be the Son of God. Let me just put a stake there. If we say that we're God's children, we ought to have some signs. Come on, somebody. Amen. If we say we've been baptized in the Holy Ghost, and we say we're saved, sanctified, and amen. Amen. On our way to heaven, speaking in tongues, worshiping God. All of this is good, but what are your signs? Because these signs shall follow the believers now. Amen. According to what it said, there's certain things a believer ought to be able to do. They can lay hands on the sick. Come on, somebody. They can cast out devils. Come on, somebody. Amen. She never called pastor. If you believe it. Come on and talk. Amen. I'm about to do this. Amen. This message. I'm about finished. Let us say amen. Glory to God. Amen. But as a believer baptized in the Holy Ghost, full of the word, there's some things that each of us ought to be able to do.
That's right. Amen.
Oh, I just heard the Holy Ghost say, amen. If you're a believer, glory to God. Amen. You're baptized in the Holy Ghost and your relationship, glory to God, is close with the Lord. Amen. Then why are you sending for somebody else to take your test?
Well,
you better pray. That's what he just told me. Amen.
Yes.
I got that revelation right here.
Yes.
Why are you seeking somebody else to take your test?
Yes.
Well, come on, somebody.
That's right.
Amen. Because if I take your test,
That means I'm going to get the grade.
That's right.
And you're going to get a zero.
That's right.
Come on, somebody. Amen. Then you're going to lose knowledge you would have gained by going through the test.
That's right.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen. And then we see how, as he moves towards Calvary, the power of the keys. In response to Peter's profession of faith in Christ's divinity, Jesus elevates him to the first among the disciples to grant him the power of the keys, the authority to bind and loose, to absolve sin and to govern the church, the body of Christ on earth. Peter is the first one that got the keys. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
He said, Peter, bind and loose. Help me somebody.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. But I'm so glad that Peter didn't keep them all. Amen. It's not on record that we have the same power. Come on, son. Because we serve the same Jesus. And the same Jesus is in us. Then we go to the transfiguration. Amen. In the presence of Peter, James, and John, Jesus is, amen, transfigured in a foretaste of the resurrection. And is seen in the presence of Moses and Elijah, represent the law and the prophets. Amen. And as at Jesus' baptism, the voice is heard from heaven saying, this is my beloved son, listen to him. And then we find, as he's going towards Calvary, the road to Jerusalem, and Jesus makes his way to Jerusalem, his passion and death, his prophetic ministry to the people of Israel becomes clear. As he entered into Jerusalem on the Palm Sunday, at the beginning of the Holy Week, Jesus enters Jerusalem, riding on a donkey to the shout of acclamations that will acknowledge him as being the Son of David and the Savior of the world. Then you have the passion and the death. The joy of the crowd of Jesus' presence is short-lived. However, during the celebration of the Passover, they turned against him and demanded his crucifixion. Jesus celebrates the Last Supper with his disciples on Holy Thursday, and then suffers death on behalf of the world on Good Friday. He spends Holy Saturday in the tomb. To the tomb. Mm-hmm. I'm on my way. But there's going to be a 3-day delay.
All right now.
Amen. The resurrection. Woo! Glory to God. After he handled business in the tomb, stepped out of mortality, mortality went into immortality, went to grave, got keys over death and hell. He steps back in. Amen. Praise God. A sense of mortality. Amen. Praise God. Then, amen. Praise God. Amen. He's on the edge of resurrection. Jesus rises from the dead, conquering death and reversing the sin of the first Adam. Mm. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And then you have the post resurrection appearance. Amen. Post mean before. Over the 40 days after the, over the 40 days after resurrection, Jesus appears to his disciples. Amen. And the Blessed Virgin Mary, explaining those portions of the gospel concerning his sacrifice that they have not understood. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He goes to Calvary. They crucify him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. His mother and women. Glory to God. I stand there. I fall. Weeping. Amen. For their son. Her son. Amen. Praise God. Amen. We know the story. Amen. Praise God. Amen. He hung there, to the sixth and the ninth hour, amen, until heaven was satisfied, amen. Jesus dropped his head in the lock of the shoulders and it's finished, the sin debt is paid, amen, the law has been fulfilled, amen. Was the law destroyed? No, but I believe it was very, even neatly tucked away. Let the church say amen. Amen. Yeah. You know how you tuck away and you put away stuff you're not going to use. You really don't want to throw it away. But you tuck it away and put it in a trunk and say, keep it. Come on, somebody. Amen. Because something greater has come. Let the church say amen. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. He stays there for 3 days and gets up on 3 nights and gets up on the third day morning. Amen. The Bible says, amen, that one of the disciples went and looked at the tombs to see was it there. Amen. Number one, the stone is rolled away. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Peter, number one, they look in there, want to know is it there. Because remember, he said, if you're up, amen, that he was going to rise on the third day morning. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Get in there. Amen. I don't know who did the house cleaning. Glory to God, but everything was folded in its proper place. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. The angels looked at him and said, who are you looking for? Glory to God. So he's not here. He is risen as he said. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And not only has he risen, amen, he's going to spend a few more days here. And then he's gone back where his father is. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
So go ahead and tell Zion. Amen. Tell the daughters of Zion. That the king is coming. And tell them that he's passing through. And he's going to be doing kingdom work. Y'all want to talk to him. You tell them that as he passed through, he's not going to be sitting down idle. Amen. But he's going to be obeying his father. Amen. And what his father said to do, he's going to do it. Because Jesus said, me and my father are one. Amen. The things I say, I heard it from my father first. Let us say amen. Oh, they got him on camera, but they couldn't keep him. Them said, I got him now. Hallelujah. Went through excruciating pain. Crucified him. Spikes in his hand. Amen. And in his scream. And it still couldn't kill him. He couldn't die before his time. Let the church say amen. He hung there until his father said, that's enough.
Yes.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. But I'm here to report that Easter is not in vain. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Not only did he rise out of the grave, but one day, over 40 some years ago, he rose in me. Come on, somebody. So I can stand to say, amen. Amen. Not happy birthday to Jesus, but happy resurrection day. I want the world to know that you don't have to live and die without resurrection. How did Jesus pay the price for the world's sin? Amen. All they got to do is open up their hearts and receive him.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Tell Zion that their king is coming.
Amen.
Tell the world that I'm going to be passing through. Amen. Tell Calvary you won't have to wait too long. And tell the tomb there'll be a 3-day delay.
All right.
Because after the 3 days, I'm going to rise on the third day.
That's right.
On my way home, resurrection day.
Amen.
Those blessings to God.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. So that's the word of encouragement today. Yes. Amen. Praise God. We hope something was said that, amen, excited your appetite for the word of God. Amen. Let us bow our heads and turn and know once God we come. And we thank you for being so kind and so merciful. Thank you, Lord, for how you have blessed us to see another Easter.
Yes.
Even through the, amen, the COVID-19.
Yes.
We still, some of us are still saying
thank you, Jesus.
Even though thank we pray for the families of those who have died, and we ask you to comfort them, with the comfort that man cannot comfort. Even in the midst of that, we are saying thank you. Hallelujah, because it could have been the other way. Amen. We pray, God, for the souls that don't know you in the pardon of their sins. That they will stop long enough and evaluate their own relationships. And let them know all of us are going to die. And all of us are going to take part of the resurrection. It just all depends in which one we're going to be part of. And that none of us, amen, want to stand before you, amen, with our business not fixed. And so we uplift the dying world today, asking you to have mercy. Help us to love them. Help us to pray for them. Help us to be that beacon light in a dark world. In the name of Jesus. Father, come. Let everybody have. Amen. Let the world stand still as they celebrate Easter. Let them know what it's all about. It's not about doing unrighteous things, but it's about being thankful that you got up and you paid the price for our sins. Thank you, Father. And we give you praise in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. I pray God will bless all of you. Amen. Praise God. I shall hope this word has been a blessing to your soul. Amen. Be nice to somebody this week. Glory to God. Amen. Be safe. Obey the laws of the land. Amen. As much as possible. Amen. Because it's been stated that this is. Amen. Praise God. In the next 2 weeks will be the peak season for COVID-19. So be very careful. I know some of us, and I'm saying, it ain't gonna touch me. And that is true. But Proverbs, the scripture in Proverbs says, wisdom will keep you safe. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
So let's walk in wisdom. God bless you, and may heaven smile upon you.